You know, it's interesting. I don't think a lot of people really know what is inside of a fire station, what occurs. I think that when they think of fire station, they think of fire trucks. They think about the fire pole, you know, coming down. Now, I think every kid has thought about, in some time in their life, you know, about dropping off that pole, right, and being a fireman and being able to go down through that. It's always been, I'm sure it's a lot of fun to be able to do that, especially if you're a kid, right? But there's so much more that goes into a fire station. Really, a fire station is a home. A lot of people don't know that the firemen spend a lot of time at that station. They live together. They need to be available 24/7. They need to be available at moment's notice in the middle of the night, woken up, and be able to get into their trucks and go answer an emergency. They eat together. They cook together. They maintain their equipment together. Spend a lot, so much in this place that there is a requirement to design this place as if it were a home. And that is how we approach it. And all the facilities that we've designed, including the fire station at Camp Smith in Hawaii, we designed it in a way that really the people inside were able to embrace this facility as a home. And note that, I mean, this facility had two fire trucks that were very active in that area. So, you know, a lot of people might think, well, maybe it's just the fire trucks, right? No, we had to design in a way that it was really livable. We designed one also a long time ago, you know, for the Phillips Laboratory at Edwards Air Force Base. And I remember one of the first criteria that they want to address is, what's our living room going to look like? Because they spent a lot of time there. What's our kitchen going to look like? And they wanted equipment that was going to be able to make that kitchen very functional, easy to clean, be able to keep all their food refrigerated properly. They didn't want one dishwasher, they wanted four dishwashers. You know, so there were a lot of things that they needed that truly were going to make their life easier there, you know, and really the time and the equipment that we spent, that we designed for in that fire station, really was quite minor compared to the livable space for those firemen. Yes, there's always been considerations. Ever since I started designing fire stations, there's always been considerations for gender. Of course, different sleeping quarters to bathing facilities, restrooms. There's always been consideration for that. Yes, they have to live together, but also there needs to be respect, you know, for the different gender. We always design for separate gender in the fire stations. We've designed primarily single story fire stations. That seems to be the preferred method. I think that the when the site is restricted, we will design a second story where the quarters, the bunks are upstairs. And then if I remember firemen showing me that when they go to bed, their boots are right there next to the bed, you know, and they're able to slide into their suit, jump in, and then go down the pole. I think hopefully they don't have any problem sleepwalking, because that could be pretty dangerous, I think. But going down the fire pole, it's still used in many instances.